Travel Leader, ATHLEAN-X.com. Today I want to talk to you about a sunken chest, or in more severe cases, something called Pectus Excavatum. You see, it's that noticeable deformity in the lower chest that sinks in down near the lower sternum that really, really can be something not just psychologically tough for those that have it, but it could actually be physically impairing because it can sort of interfere with your ability to expand your own lungs or even have your heart contract without beating against the sternum itself. So what I want to do is sort of give you a game plan to, number one, figure out how severe is your sunken chest. Is it something simply that is cosmetic, or is it really kind of bordering more on that line of interfering with your physiology? So what are we talking about? Well, let's look at a couple pictures. This picture right here, this would be what I call a mild form of this. Now, as a matter of fact, I actually don't have the best pec development myself, and what we do is sometimes confuse poor lower pec development because of attachments with this sunken chest. So if you look here at me, this pec here noticeably kind of takes a little hard left turn compared to this one that's a little bit more full. This is simply having distal attachments or further out on the sternum than this, which makes this sort of look wider at the bottom and creates a little bit of a hole here in the lower sternum. But that's something that, again, we can't change muscle attachments. What we can do is try our best to develop that. But this picture right here, this is definitely pectus excavatum. You can see a major hole here or sink in the bottom of the chest that can probably, in this case, start bordering on those physiological implications that I talked about in the beginning. If you have this, I'm gonna tell you here right now, guys, I never bullshit you and I tell you the truth. If it's this bad and it's actually making you more fatigued or it's getting in the way of your ability to do endurance events, because of this limitation on lung expansion, you're probably gonna have to look the surgical route. The good news is this, there's two procedures now. One of them is the Nuss procedure that they actually go in and correct this, almost like the same way you would brace your teeth, a long duration change to the sternum by actually bracing it and trying to pull it outward, right? By putting a bar in there and trying to pull it outward. The second thing is actually a little bit more optimistic because it's less invasive, and it's a metallic bar, a magnetic bar, that they put in the lower chest and then externally fixate a brace that will pull that out over time. But both of them are long duration fixes. You're gonna have to have that on for a long period of time, just like you would braces for your teeth. So what I wanna do is say, look, even if you have those conditions and you wanna try to do something in the gym, something that's in your power that's not going to require that, what I show you here today is going to help you. If you have a much more minor version of this, like I showed you in the beginning, what I'm gonna show you here today is going to help you as well. So the first thing you wanna do is adjust your posture. Why? Because we know that if your chest is sunken in, the first thing that's gonna happen is you're going to get tightness, mostly in your pec major and pec minor, which is going to round your shoulders down, further creating a sunken chest, right? If it's already hollow and I do this, and I lift up here and show you, and I do that, everything sinks in even more. Now what we have to do is stretch those two muscles, and instead of making this video a million minutes long, what I've done is I've already done a video in depth on how to, I even broke out the muscle marker, on how to stretch the pec major and the pec minor, specifically, each one. And I want you to make sure that you do that. And then what I want to show you is the other things you can do, and it's not just the exercises, guys, it's the how-to on the exercises that's going to matter the most. And right away we start with working the other side, because when you stretch a muscle on this side, you wanna make sure that you strengthen the muscles on the opposite side. So we gotta make sure that those rhomboids and mid-scapular muscles are strong enough to handle the posture that you have to now recreate and retrain. So we do that with band pull-aparts. And when we do that, we stand back, we actually don't just do them from here with a sunken chest. You always have to make sure that you're creating the condition in the positioning that you want. So you try to protract your chest out, lift your sternum is what I say. If your sternum is pointing down here, the angle of it pointing down, lift it up until it's right straight ahead so I can rest a glass of water on top of it. From here is where I do my band pull-aparts. Right from here, and I pull back, and I hold. And the idea here is to get your shoulder blades retracted, pull together, and down. And now what I want to do is, I don't want to do one set of 20 here. What I'd rather have you do is 20 sets of one. Execute each rep as if it's the only one you're gonna do, and then retrain your muscles to contract in that position. So right here, the quality is always gonna be better than quantity. And as I transition here to some of the other exercises that you're gonna wanna do, focus on how I'm telling you to do this and not just what to do. Because everybody always tells you what to do, but they don't tell you how. And the how is much more important because you're trying to create a long-term change. If you're not gonna have a brace on here 24/7, you need to be able to do things that are gonna have an impact on it. And guess what? You're likely gonna have to own this program. Meaning, you're gonna have to take ownership of the fact that your special circumstances require you to do much more than the average person who doesn't have this. But if you're okay with that, then that's cool, because I'm gonna show you exactly how that's done. When you bench press, let's hold off on creating mass as the major focus at this moment, because you can always do that. This is more of a kind of a repetitive program that you would do 3 or 4 or 5 times a week in small doses. Why? Because we're trying to create that brace-like effect. So when I bench, as I pull the dumbbells down, you actually want to pull the dumbbells down and move the chest up and pause at the bottom of the rep. And at the same time, you're trying to pull your stomach in, contract your abs, because you want to make sure that whenever you are expanding your rib cage, you're getting a co-contraction of your abs at the same time, because the sunkenness actually results in this sunken chest, but also a distending stomach. You lose ab tightness and strength when you have pectus excavatum. So we want to be able to contract that, pull that in, and then lift the chest up. That will actually help to, you know, make the appearance of this start looking better. So when I do that on the bench press, I pull down and pull, push out at the same time. It's literally an active movement. I'm not just coming down here, I'm coming down and moving my chest up towards the ceiling as far as I possibly can, hanging out at the bottom here and then coming back up out of it. Again, this is not what the chest training session looks like. That's still doing the same technique, but with heavier weights in an effort to build. This is the repetitive 3, 4, 5 time a week program that you do 3 sets at a time, just as if you would do rotator cuff work 3 or 4 times a week to try to overcome a weak rotator cuff. It's the repetitive stuff. Next, we have another great exercise, the dumbbell pullover. The dumbbell pullover helps us to create the rib expansion. At the same time, it requires us to contract your abs, if you're doing it right, because a lot of people don't do that portion of it. So we come down here with a dumbbell, put your shoulder blades right on the top of the bench, okay? Then, don't leave yourself up here in the air like that. Drop down. Just by dropping all the way down, I've already extended the rib cage and expanded the rib cage. When I breathe in, here, I've got this massive expansion of the rib cage, but at the same time, as I come back up, I'm breathing out and tightening the abs at the same time here to create that core contraction while I have the expanded chest. So don't just do pullovers. Pullovers alone is not gonna do it, guys. You wanna have the right performance of it. As I said in the beginning, I'd rather you do 20 sets of 1 than 1 set of 20 here. Come all the way down, it's dropped, expanded, tight abs. And don't be afraid to hang out down here, because again, we're going more for that brace-like effect, making change. Look, if you're younger, you're an adolescent, you've got soft bones still, you can actually change your bone. That's what happens when you have braces. You're actually changing the bone that your teeth are anchored into. It just takes a very, very long effort, prolonged effort, over the course of many, many days, many, many workouts, many, many hours. So don't think you're going to make these massive changes in a pectus condition just by running to the gym and doing a couple pullovers or bench press. That's not how it works. Same thing here. Dips. When you do your dips, another good exercise, lower portion of the chest. What you do is you do the same thing you did on the bench press. When I come down, I'm not just dropping here at my elbows. In fact, if I do that and I do this, I'm actually just sinking my chest in more, right? Just recreating the same positioning here. What I wanna do is I wanna go down at the same time that I'm pushing out my chest, pulling my shoulder blades back together, and of course tightening the abs that way and up. That way and up. Breathing in. And again, hanging out at the bottom here. This is not meant to go to failure every single set with the fact of overdoing your chest work, because that's not how you build a bigger chest either. You gotta give it a chance to recover. This is more of that remedial stuff that you're doing on a consistent basis. Another exercise here, got two left. But what we do is we take a dumbbell, a single dumbbell, and we pull it up and across. So we're literally just adducting from the arm this way up and across the body, trying to get a lift up and across. Okay, initiate the movement from the chest. You're not lifting with your front delt here. You're initiating with a contraction of the chest on the inside here. Okay, again, more longer duration work. Finally, we have a stomach vacuum. Now, the stomach vacuum is another exercise I went much more in depth on that I'll link over here so that you can see the more the nuances of it. But the good thing about the stomach vacuum is you are teaching yourself to, again, expand your rib cage and at the same time contract your abs and bring them in. So we can create this differential here and try to, as best we can, try to cosmetically reverse that sunken in chest. So here's the bottom line on all of this. Whether you have a minor case of pectus excavatum, whether you have just a little bit of a different attachment of the lower pecs that create a wideness and sort of a sunkenness on the lower chest, whether you have a severe case of pectus, guys, there's a lot of things you can do to develop the rest of your body, and don't let that define you. Don't ever let what you feel self-conscious about define you. And I realize that when people say, when they point to themselves, they usually point right here. In this particular case, this issue is right where you're pointing. So it sort of reinforces all those negative thoughts that you might have. But remember this, guys, everybody has something that holds them back. And there's always something you can do. Let it motivate you to do something about it. Let it motivate you to train the rest of your body to make people take notice of that instead. But you can do something about it. And whether you go down the surgical route, and that's what helps you to fix that condition, or whether you go down this route here and it helps with the minor cases to at least become more cosmetically in control of what you have going on here, just make sure you do what I'm telling you. Forget about just doing the exercises. That alone is not going to help you. It's how you do the exercises, and it's the quality of what you do, and it's the frequency. Can't say that enough. The frequency. Adopt this as your program. Other people will have their things they have to do to maintain whatever it is that they're dealing with. Your program happens to be this, and it's something you're gonna have to stick with and own if you wanna make permanent changes. But I know if this is something that bothers you, it's gonna be something that you will do. In the meantime, guys, I hope you found this video helpful. Here we've always put the science back in strength, and we try not to bullshit you about anything. I try to give the exact answers to whatever it is you're dealing with. I do the same thing with all of our training programs. Over at ATHLEAN-X.com, all of our programs, no BS, step by step, we put the science back in strength. Those are all available over there. In the meantime, let me know what else you wanted me to cover here on this channel, because this was a direct response to all the requests that I got from you viewers out there that wanted me to do something on this. All right, guys, I'll see you soon.